There was an anthropologist who had been studying the habits and culture of a remote African tribe. He had been working in the village for quite some time, and the day before he was to return home, he put together a gift basket filled with delicious fruits from around the region and tied it with a ribbon. He placed the basket under the tree and then he gathered up the children in the village. The man drew a line in the dirt, looked at the children and said, "When I tell you to start, run to the tree, and whoever gets there first will win the full basket of fruits." Now when he told them to run, they all took each other's hands and ran together to the tree. Then they sat together around the basket and enjoyed that treat as a group. The anthropologist was shocked. He asked why they would all go together when one of them could have won all the fruits for themselves. And a young girl looked up at him and said, "How can one of us be happy if all the other ones are sad?" Years later, the well-known South African activist Bishop Desmond Tutu would describe the little girl's thought process by using the word Ubuntu, which means "I am because we are." He further explained the concept, stating the term Ubuntu implying we believe that a person is a person through other persons. It embraces hospitality, caring about others, being willing to go an extra mile for the sake of another. Now, Ubuntu is a term derived from the word Muntu, meaning a person, a human being. And according to the ancient African traditional wisdom, each individual possesses some positive, loving qualities. And the values of Ubuntu manifest in good deeds, things like being sensitive to the needs of others, being compassionate, forgiving, caring, and generous. Ubuntu is a reminder that no one is an island. Every single thing that you do, good or bad, has an effect on your family, friends, and society. It also reminds us that we need to think twice about the choices we want to make and the kind of impact they may have on others. I read an African proverb that says, "If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together." Nelson Mandela once said, "A traveler through a country would stop at a village and he didn't have to ask for food or water. Once he stops, the people give him food and entertain him." That is one aspect of Ubuntu, but it will have various other aspects. Now, Mandela lived in the true definition of Ubuntu, as he used this concept to lead South Africa to a peaceful post-apartheid transition. He never had the intention of teaching his oppressors a lesson. Instead, he operated with a compassion and integrity, showing that for a better South Africa, one cannot act out of vengeance or retaliation, but out of peace. Now, there are three basic pillars of Ubuntu living that I can summarize: share, care, and be fair. First, sharing. Sharing is about giving to others without expecting anything in return. It is the recognition of the fact that irrespective of your financial circumstances, you must remember there is always someone else worse off than you. Second is caring. You can share, but it's of no use if you don't care. Caring is about making other people's needs your needs. It is putting the problems and interests and circumstances of others at a higher level of attention. Third, be fair. You can share and care, but the deepest concern for others comes from being fair. One needs to be fair to both oneself and others. A human being from an Ubuntu perspective should be kind, generous, and friendly to others, be respectful to the environment, live in harmony with oneself, and above all, be one with the Creator. Now, Matthew Ricard is a French writer and a Buddhist monk who resides at a monastery in Nepal, and he received his PhD degree in molecular genetics from the Pasteur Institute in about 1972. And he is often regarded as the happiest man in the world. On the basis of a 12 years brain study on meditation and compassion led by neuroscientists from the University of Wisconsin, Richard Davidson. Now, in this book that I read, according to Richard, the key to happiness lies in one's ability to stop thinking of me, me, and more of me, and putting other people first. He says that the best thing people can do to be happy is to do something for others. Kindness leads to happiness, according to the Buddhist monk. That is why, remember this, be kind to the kind and be kind to the unkind. The reason is that thinking about you and how to make things better for yourself all the time is exhausting and stressful, and it ultimately leads to unhappiness. He says the me, me, me all day long is very stuffy and is quite miserable because you instrumentalize the whole world as a threat or as a potential sort of interest to yourself. He says acting with other people's welfare in mind can transform us one by one until ultimately we create an altruistic revolution. He defines altruism as simply the wish that other people may be happy. Matthew Ricard says, if you want to be happy, you should strive to be benevolent, meaning kind-hearted, which not only makes you feel better, but also makes others like you more. He further said that if your mind is filled with benevolence, then you will have a healthy mental state and your body will be healthier, and that too will be perceived by people around you as something nice. Research studies have indicated that the quality of human relations is one of the major factors of well-being and happiness. Malcolm X, an African-American leader and supporter of the Black nationalism, once said, "When the I in your life is replaced by we, then even illness is replaced by wellness." To sum up, I'd like to quote William Atherwood. He says three keys to a more abundant living: caring about others, daring for others, and sharing with others.